Okay, so I kind of want to make this really quick video on how to get macOS Sequoia beta running on UTM. So first thing you're going to need to download is UTM. So all you're going to do is just hit download here and save it. Second thing you're going to need to go to is go to the second link. You're going to scroll down and see Xcode 16 beta. Today we're not actually going to be installed Xcode 16 beta, so don't worry about that. But there is a certain file we're going to need to use in Xcode 16 beta. That's will maybe take up 50 megabytes or so. It's not big, but we just need to grab it out of this. So also download this file. And lastly, you're actually going to need the macOS 15 beta file itself. So go to the next URL. It's going to be in your developer account under macOS 15 beta, and you're just going to click download restore image and also download that. I'm not going to walk you through installing UTM, as most people should know how to do that. With the latest beta, there's actually a weird bug with UTM where it can't actually fetch the necessary dependencies it needs to run the new macOS Sequoia. So a workaround is you can actually get it from the new Xcode beta. You right click, go to show package contents, go to contents, you scroll down, you look for resources, you go to packages, and all you need to do is, do you see this one right here, mobiledevice.pkg? All you need to do is install this guy, and then you should be good to go. So if we open up UTM, all you need to do is hit create a new virtual machine, virtualize, macOS. You're gonna browse and find that file. So this is about a 15 gigabyte file. It was the one we got from Apple Developer. Open it. We're gonna allocate about 8 gigs because I have 16, but you can choose this on your own. Hit continue. I'm gonna do 64 gigs because I don't need a lot of storage. And hit save. Now, one more recommendation I have is before you open it up, most of you are going to be on Mac like me. I'm on a MacBook Air 15 inch. So what you're going to do is you're just going to find your computer and it'll match it when it opens up the thing. So as you can see, this matches my model. Some of you will be a MacBook Pro, and that's it. All you need to do from now is just hit play, hit OK. And then this will take quite some time, so be patient. You can watch up here on the installation. This will slowly go up. This will take a very long time, so be prepared. But as you can see, it is using quite a bit of my CPU right now, and it's starting to work on it. But this can take a couple of minutes, so I'll be right back once it's all complete and installed. All right, so after the installation is complete, you should be on a screen like this, and this is actually the setup screen for macOS Sequoia. So all you need to do is you just run through the setup just like any other Mac, and you'll be good to go. One more recommendation is full screen, and now it will match your display perfectly. So this will make it a lot easier during setup or if you're doing any developer testing. So yeah, after that, you should be good to go. It's actual macOS Sequoia. I can show you that by pulling up the brand new passwords app that was showcased at WWDC this year. And you can see we have the password app up right here. So yeah, this is how you get it up and running for development purposes. If this helped you, leave a like, because I know a lot of people are struggling to stop it.